What are the things I need to possess him? In other words, there are certain things I need to throw away from my life. There are certain things my heart need to possess from the Lord. Hunger for the Lord. Hunger from the Lord. These are the two things we need to do. The Lord spoke to Malachi. Even today, he speaks to us. Close your eyes. Hunger for him. When the Lord came to Zechariah, Zechariah could not believe the Lord. And he became a dumb man. God comes to us. But if you are not open to him, if you don't allow him to burn you, you will be burnt. Yes. So, when Zechariah, like exactly like Mother Mary, but Mother Mary said, I am God's servant, let his will be done. She surrendered to God. By surrendering her weakness, surrendering her situation, she said, how is it possible? She was frightened. She was disturbed. The word used was bewildered. Is more than disturbed, more than frightened. She was bewildered. But when the Lord spoke, there is nothing impossible for God. She said, after all, my life is only once on this earth. After all, I am created for my God. And I have dedicated my life to him. And I cannot walk in two. My one leg in one place and another one with another desire. I am going to fall. Open my eyes to the truth. And then she said, here I am. Let God's will be done in my life. And then she brought Jesus. Today the Lord is the same Lord. Comes to Zechariah. Zechariah says, no, it's not possible. No, I am old man. No, my wife is, I know. Maybe not now. Many things he might have thought. But he did not open his heart. He closed his heart. Not knowing. If you close yourself to your God, the enemy will close your mouth. The enemy will destroy your life. If you don't open to the Lord, you are going to be closed by the enemy. This is what Zechariah learned. The moment he was told to us, what is the name? He says, John. Let the Lord be glorified. There is nothing impossible for God. When he confessed, once again the mouth gets opened. Your life and your death is on your lips. Your life and your death happens. What do you do with your heart? Happiness is basically is an inside job. Inside of your mind and heart, what's happening? Everybody has problem. Who doesn't have problem? Everybody has disturbances and temptation attacking them. But what do you do? Do you move with the Lord? As we read in the book of Romans 8:13, by the Spirit, you destroy the flesh that attacks you. By the Spirit. So your focus is on hungering for the Spirit. And with the Spirit, you destroy the flesh. To put it in blunt way, as in Peter beautifully says like this, chapter 2, verse 11, he will say like that, beloved, I beg you, Peter says, I beg you, as sojourners, means you are a travelers, you are not a permanent, this world is not permanent, we are sojourners and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts, which war against your soul. Be alert There are forces that are getting warring. They are doing war against your soul. If you are not alert, you are gone. Be alert to the forces they are fighting against. They want your soul, nothing else. So be alert, he says. Abstain from fleshly lusts, through which he is warring against your soul. You will read from chapter 1, verse 13 onwards. He will say three things. So when the enemy is doing war against your soul, you have to be alert. And the moment only when you hold on to the Spirit, your mouth gets open. Until then, you remain as a dumb. So God has not thrown us away to die in sin. He has sent us his Son, Jesus. So life comes not because the sin is so powerful. Man dies not because sin is so powerful. Man dies because he is not holding on to life. He is not hungering for life. So, when he is not in the light, without his permission, the darkness enters into his life. Man's destruction is because he is not holding on to the light, the darkness has found its place in me. That's why in the book of Isaiah chapter 64, verse 7, the prophet literally cries saying, why? There is nobody who are holding on to the Lord, who are hungering to hold on to the Lord. As we prepare for the Christmas, maybe things can help us. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13 onwards. Therefore, gird up the joints of your mind. So first you have to see your mind. You have to check the thoughts of your mind. Gird up means gird up lion's center. Means what? You tie up on your waist because your dress should not become an obstacle for you to work or to walk. If your dress is there, somewhere something is there, it will catch. Dirt it will catch, thorn bushes. So you tie it up, your cloth, with the lines so it is close to your body. So it doesn't become an obstacle for you. The same way, you have to tie up your mind. That's what St. Peter says. If you don't check your mind, and what are the ways through which your mind can be caught up, which are getting, we are being caught up now, you have to check. And you have to tie up your mind. In 1 Corinthians 9, St. Paul says, after preaching to everybody, I should not be lost. So I beat up my body and keep my mind where it is supposed to be. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, 27. It is very important, for which we have to ask the Holy Spirit. 2 Timothy 1, 7 says, we have not received spirit of fear, but spirit of courage, spirit of love, that you need not run around the world. God will supply enough love for you and self-discipline. You have to gird up. Self-discipline means gird up your mind. You have to tie up your mind.